Jonah, when you look at the Cubs signing of Yu Darvish, does that make them the odds-on favorite in the NL?
I don't know that I'd say that. I still think the Dodgers might be the best team in the NL. Of course, they're the team that lost Darvish. But you look at L.A., and you know, they're a very good team. They're a very complete team, and they have a lot of young guys, too, right? Their best players are guys like Seager and Bellinger, and even Kershaw is still in his 20s. So I don't know about that. But the Cubs are certainly very good. There's no question about that. And, you know, not just Darvish, the acquisition of Tyler Chatwood, they got the depth back that they needed. They lose Arrieta. Lackey retires, but, you know, Quintana, again, a mid-season trade. So you're going to get a full year of Quintana. Of course, you're going to get Darvish and Chatwood for the full year. And Lester and Hendricks are back, and those were the two best guys in that rotation anyway, with Arrieta kind of falling off a little bit. You add Brandon Morrow and Steve Cishek to the bullpen. Hopefully mitigate some of the loss of Wade Davis, who, of course, is excellent. And we'll see. I think if you're looking for a turning point, though, it's the lineup, because they didn't touch it at all. They're going to run back with the same guys that they had. All eight projected starters are under 29 years old. That's a very good sign. Usually young players improve, but there are question marks, right? Kyle Schwarber, he kind of tailed off in 2017. Addison Russell, problems both on the field and off. You know, Jason Hayward, where's the bat? Is he ever going to hit? So this is a pretty good group of position players, but if some of these guys improve, and again, they are young, they're mid-20s, then that sets up for what could be a good team goes to potentially great team as they were in 2016.